as Prabhupada mentions in the purport. Hata medasaha means those whose brains are spoiled. Only such people worship the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord for some material benediction. Why? What is wrong in praying to Vishnu for good health, good education, getting a good job, making some money, living a comfortable life, having a good family, the welfare of one's family members? What is wrong in praying to Vishnu for all these things? Why are you saying my brain is spoiled if I worship to Vishnu and ask for some welfare of myself as well as my family members? What's wrong? So for that, Karada Muni is saying, because why they are called Hatamedasa is because such kind of kamalavaya, such kind of material desires for the welfare of oneself as well as one's family members, kama nireyepi yesyuhu, such kind of desires can be fulfilled even in the hellish planets. What we have to understand is, hellish planet does not mean that there is only suffering there. There is a lot of opulence there in the hellish planets also. There also you can have a family. There also you can enjoy your senses. All such facilities are there. Some of the descriptions of some of the hellish planets which is made indicates that the opulence in the heavenly hellish planets is more than that in the earthly planet. The point is, why they are called then hellish is because in those planets the opportunity and the culture of practicing spiritual life is absent. In Swargalokas, they are heavenly planets, they are more elevated because the consciousness of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is higher. In the heavenly planets, it is filled with people who are devotees of Vishnu. In the hellish planets, it is all people who are non-devotees. It's not that there are no facilities there or no conveniences there. Conveniences are there, maybe even better than what you find on this earthly planet. But because there is no consciousness of the Supreme Lord, they are called hellish planets. Nireyepi, the word nireyepi can be interpreted in two ways. That it can refer to the hellish planets, or it can refer to the hellish life of animals. Even in animals also, eating, sleeping, mating and defending activities are going on comfortably, much more comfortably than in human beings. Not only that, in the animal kingdom, the animals do not have to endeavor as much as the human beings for meeting the necessities of eating, sleeping, mating and defending. And because again, animals do not have any consciousness of the Supreme Lord, therefore, even animal society is considered hellish society, niraya. Karada Muni is saying, this kind of taking care of one's family members, one's own welfare, engaging in sense gratification, enjoying the processes of eating, sleeping, mating and defending, this is there even amongst the animal kingdom. This is there even in the hellish planets, without any God consciousness, without any understanding that there is a God above us, simply enjoying the eating, sleeping, mating and defending is something which is available in the animal kingdom as well as the hellish planets. So therefore, if one wants to enjoy simply the eating, sleeping, mating and defending processes, then what is the need to worship Vishnu? So only a foolish person, one who is a mudha, who is a foolish person, will worship Vishnu and ask for some material boons to enjoy one's senses in this material world. Therefore, he is saying, nireyepi yesihu kaman. So somebody may say that, okay, you are saying that the material sense gratification, that the facilities for material sanskritification are there even in the animal kingdom as well as hellish planets. So there is no point in worshipping Vishnu's lotus feet for that. But what is the harm if we worship Vishnu's lotus feet and get those material pleasures rather than by engaging in activities devoid of Vishnu and enjoying those senses? So the problem is, as Kardama Muni is mentioning here, Padarvindam Bhavasindhu Potam. If a poor person, he approaches a very rich person, let us say, very rich man, multi-billionaire. A poor man approaches him, and the multi-billionaire, looks at the poor man, he takes compassion upon him, and he says, "Tell me, what do you want? I am ready to give anything that you ask." So what should the poor man ask? He can ask any big thing. He can ask $1 billion, or he can say, "You give me a company worth $1 million so that my continuous profits I can keep generating and my livelihood is taken care of." Or you can ask any big benediction like that. But if you go and tell him, "I'm very hungry today, please give me $1 so that I can go and buy some sandwich and eat," what will you tell about such a person? Foolish man. This rich man, he can give you billions, and you're going and asking for some pennies. That man will laugh and he will tell, "Oh, you are coming to me and asking this. You might as well have not come to me. Anyway, you have come. Chalo, take. You are asking for $1. Take and go." But the rich man, when he is giving that, he will be thinking, "Foolish man. He could have asked for anything. He is asking for $1. What is this foolishness?" This is what he will think. Same way, Kardama Muni is saying, the lotus feet of Vishnu are capable of Bhavasindhu Potam. They are capable of acting as the boat by which we can cross over the ocean of nescience, the ocean of repeated birth, death, disease and old age. Once for all our material miseries can be destroyed simply by worshipping the lotus feet of Vishnu. So, to take advantage of the worship of the lotus feet of Vishnu is to cross over the ocean of birth and death. What is the point in going to Vishnu, who can deliver us from this material world of repeated birth and death, and going and asking him for some small temporary sense gratification? What is the use? It is a misuse of the great facility offered by Vishnu in the form of his lotus feet. Therefore, all great personalities, all great devotees have this realization. What is the realization that they have? The same thing which Kardama Muni is mentioning here. Padaravindam Bhavasindhu Potam. The lotus feet of Mahavishnu are the boat by which we can cross over the ocean of nescience, the ocean of ignorance, the ocean of miseries, the ocean of birth and death in this material world.